Yes. PST, 12th class, chapter 11, marketing management, and the topic is product mix. We are doing here product mix, and as you all know that it has three important decisions: branding, packaging, and labeling. Branding we have already done, we have already discussed in the previous classes. So today I'm going to discuss packaging. So what is packaging? Packaging does not mean in marketing, does not mean only putting the product in the packet. It does not mean only putting the product in package. So in normal or in general language, packaging means keeping the product or putting the product. Putting the product in package. But packaging is much more here in marketing. Packaging involves not only putting the product or keeping the product in the packet, but it also includes the manufacturing of all the packaging material. So how we can define packaging? Yes. Packaging, you all can write the definition of packaging. You must have seen that whenever we buy a good from the market, that nowadays open products are not preferable by anyone. So everything comes in a packaged form. Like biscuit you are buying, then they comes in wrapper, chocolate in wrapper, shampoo in bottle, cream, fairness cream or any ointment, medicinal cream that comes in tube, toothpaste in tube. And for the fragile products, the packaging is also very important. Just like you are buying any glass product or refrigerator or any electronic items, TV and all. So all these are also packaged for providing them extra safety, extra protection. So similarly, all the edible products, all the other durable or semi-durable goods, and everything is available in the package in the market. And now onwards, the consumers are even not ready to buy the open product, especially the food items. Why? Just because of the fear of adulteration in the products. So packaging saves the product from adulteration also. So what is packaging? So packaging refers to the act of designing and producing the container. This is the packaging material: container, jar, bottle, box, wrapper, tin, etc. So all these examples are of packaging material. So in definition, what you can write, packaging refers to the act of designing and producing the packaging material. Producing the packaging material. And there is a great difference in between packing and packaging. In normal term, in normal life, a layman can use both the terms in same way. But in marketing or in business terms, both words have different meaning. Packing means just putting the product in the packet. Like you have prepared, you have manufactured the wrappers and chocolates. So when you are putting the chocolates in the wrapper, then it is known as packing. And packaging means designing and producing the container, box, wrapper, bottle. It means all the packaging material in which the product is available. Nowadays, you can see that some products are also available in jute bag. So that bag is also a packaging. Clear? So packaging is very important for each and every product. And just because of its importance, it is also known as silent salesman. Silent salesman. Packaging is known as silent salesman. What is the duty of salesman? You all know that salesman performs the function of selling the product. Selling of product. Clear? salesman performs the function of selling of product. Not only selling, now how he will be able to sell, to convince the consumer. By convincing the consumer. So he is convincing the consumer. Convincing means persuading, forcing the consumer to buy that particular product which he is showing him. He will be telling all the features of the product, quality of the product, MRP of the product, and what are the ingredients in the product. If the customer is having any query about the product, all the queries will be solved out by the salesman. So nowadays, you can see that there is a mall culture. And when we go to mall for shopping, then there is no need of salesmen, specifically in the food store. Salesmen are not convincing you. They are not telling you until you are asking anything from them. Why? Because everything is arranged on the racks in the packaged form. So you need not to ask about the MRP, ingredients, directions for use, quantity, manufacturing date. Everything is mentioned on the package in the form of label. So you can just, there is no need of weighing the product because weight is also written on the packet. You need to just pick the packet and drop in your shopping cart. So this all has become convenient just because of packaging. This all has become convenient just because of packaging. So packaging is a silent salesman. Why? Because salesman will be telling each and everything to the consumer. Packaging itself is a salesman. It need not to tell anything. Packaging itself is a salesman because there is no need to speak up. Packaging, all the information, important information is written on the package itself and the consumer can read all the information. So there is no need of a salesman. So that's why it is known as a silent salesman. And it is a very important 3-marker question. Why packaging is known as silent salesman? So you have to explain in detail whatever I have told you. Clear? So packaging is a part of product mix and it is very important. And it is known as a silent salesman. So now, what are the different levels of packaging or the types of the packaging which are done by a producer or the manufacturer? So packaging is of 3 types. What are 3 types? Primary packaging, secondary packaging, and transportation packaging. Primary, secondary, and transportation packaging. Anurag, you are not clearly visible. Yes. So primary packaging, first packaging is primary packaging. I can show you all the 3 levels in this slide. You can see first level where the number 1 is written, that is the primary packaging. Second is the secondary packaging and third is the transportation packaging. Primary packaging means the immediate layer of the protection of the product. Immediate layer of the product. So we can say the container, the tube, the jar, the wrapper in which the product is actually kept is known as primary packaging. In which the product is actually kept is known as primary packaging. Sometimes the primary packaging may be of 2 types. Like sometimes the product primary package remains till the consumer is ready to use. Like plastic packages for socks, package of a bathing sock, etc. And sometimes the package, primary package is in the form till the product will be finally used. For example, suppose you have purchased a pair of socks. So mostly the socks come in a plastic packet. So as soon as you will start using socks, you will throw the primary packet. ऐसा ही होता है ना, ऐसा तो नहीं होता कि आप आज स्कूल में सॉक्स पहनकर आए हैं फिर घर जाके वापस आप पैकेट में डाल के रख देंगे. इज इट सो? ऐसा कभी भी नहीं होता है. सो दिस इज नोन एज प्राइमरी पैकेट विच इज थ्रोन समटाइम्स, विच इज थ्रोन एट द टाइम ऑफ यूजिंग द प्रोडक्ट. सो इट विल बी थ्रोन फॉर ऑलवेज. एंड वन मोर टाइप ऑफ प्राइमरी पैकेज, दैट इज द एडिशनल लेयर. सो नॉट एडिशनल लेयर, वी कैन से लाइक ट्यूब. शैम्पू बॉटल, you have purchased a shampoo which has come in a bottle and this bottle will be retained till the product is finally consumed. When the shampoo will be finished, only then you will be throwing the bottle. Same is with the toothpaste tube. The toothpaste tube will be kept with the customer. The toothpaste tube will be kept with the customer until it is finally used. It will be never thrown. As soon as it will be finished, you may throw it. Okay. So this primary packaging refers to the product's immediate container in which the product is actually kept. Product is actually kept means the immediate layer which provides the protection. For example, tube of a toothpaste. If you want to buy any fairness cream, that also comes in a tube, like wrapper of the chocolate. Whenever we buy wrapper chocolate, then it comes in a wrapper. Packet of chips, that is the primary package. So I hope this is clear. And primary package sometimes is of two type. First, which can be thrown at the time of use, like I have given you example of socks. Socks come in a plastic package, and as soon as you start using socks, that will be thrown. So secondary package, second is the secondary package. Secondary package is basically an additional layer. An additional layer which gives extra protection. Additional layer which gives extra protection to the product. For example, you have purchased a toothpaste tube. So basically the toothpaste comes in a tube, that is the primary package. Then that tube is kept in a cardboard box. So that is the cardboard box is the additional layer, which is known as secondary package. Similarly, sometimes when we buy a biscuit, and if the biscuits are expensive biscuits, then firstly they are packed in a plastic packet, in a wrapper, then they are put in a cardboard box like Dark Fantasy. They are having some little bit higher price. So whenever we will be adding a secondary layer, it will be definitely adding the cost to the product, because secondary layer means some extra cost. No doubt it will be giving you protection to your product, extra protection. It will protect the product from moisturizer, heat, sunlight, rain, pesticide, etc. But definitely it will be adding to the cost of the product. So while doing your project work, you have to select the different levels of packaging. This line I am telling you in relation to your project work in marketing. Okay, so if you want to increase the price of your product, or if your product is already expensive, then you can add the second layer. Otherwise, no need to add the second layer for the cost benefit of the consumer. Third level, which is necessary. Secondary level is not necessary. First level and transportation packaging, which is the third level, is very important and are done for each and every product. So transportation packaging is done for transporting the goods from the place of manufacturing to the place of consumption. We all know that goods are manufactured at one place, but they will be consumed at different places throughout the country or beyond the country. We can say the international market. So those goods are need to be transported there. So how they will be transported? In cartons. So this packing is known as transportation packaging. So in this cartons, cardboard cartons, the goods are kept in 100 units, 20 units, 500 units, depending on the size and the nature of the goods. Sometimes the good is of nature that needs refrigeration. So at that time, the packaging instructions are mentioned on the product. So these are the different levels of packaging which are to be adopted by each and every manufacturer. Now, one more important thing, it is not necessary that the packaging material is produced by the manufacturer of the product himself. He can get this service outsourced. This point I am telling you for your knowledge. It is not related to this chapter. Outsourcing, you all have studied in 11th class. So like, just talk about Haldiram's. Whenever we buy any product from Haldiram's, suppose sweets we are buying, or we are doing any home delivery, then the product are kept in very good boxes, attractive boxes, or which may be of plastic boxes or cardboard boxes. Now it is not necessary that all the packaging material is manufactured or produced by Haldiram himself, because his core activity is satisfying the need of the customer, producing the sweets and dealing in food items. So if he will be, it will be concentrating on producing of packaging material, then it may not be having proper time to give attention for the core activities. So if it is easy for the manufacturer, then he can have his own packaging unit. He can buy packaging machines and hire the packaging staff, and he can install, establish his own packaging unit. But if it is not possible, because it will be also requiring the investment by him, maybe all the investors, all the manufacturers are not in a position to invest a lot of money in producing packaging material. So what they can do, they can outsource it from the outside. They can give the contract to the some other party, and whose main business is only producing the packaging material. Okay, so the next is functions or importance of packaging. Why packaging is important? When we are doing packaging, we are spending some extra amount on in doing packaging. Then why? Because the packaging is important. It is performing some functions. That's why we are spending money on packaging. Nowadays, you can see that very innovative packages are available in the market. Like if you have ever been heard about the Amul Moti milk, the packaging is now so innovative that the goods are not spoiled just because of heat and moisture. You all must have heard that the milk is spoiled. It's a perishable good, and it is spoiled within a 2 days or 3 days. And specifically in the summer, it can be spoiled in 1 day if it is not kept under refrigeration. Clear? But Amul has launched a milk which is named as Moti milk, and it can be kept outside also, and its life is 90 days. You can see this product in different malls and in different shops, 90 days, and it does not need any refrigeration. How it has become possible? Just because of its packing, Tetra Pak. Just because of its packing. So this type of packaging is also known as innovative packaging. You nowadays, you can see that all many of your mothers of many students are a working woman. Say, so many times we don't have time to prepare food at home. So to give facility, this facility to the working women, the ready-to-eat products are launched. Ready-to-eat products are launched. You can have different branded ready-to-eat products. Ready-to-eat products means the product is already prepared, and that is packaged in a packing in such a manner that it will not be spoiled. And what you need to do, you just go to market, buy the ready-to-eat product, and come back to home, microwave it. Just microwave it, and you can have it. How it has become possible? Just because of packaging. So packaging is nowadays so innovative that products, we can keep the product safe for a longer time. So that is the importance of packaging. And you can see many more examples in your daily life just because for the packaging. All products in the market are available in the packaged form. So when everyone is doing packaging, even the customers are also preferring the packaged products, then why? Some importance is there. So the first point of product importance is product protection. Product protection. Packaging provides protection to the product. Protection from what? Protection from damage. Appropriate packaging protects the product from sun, rain, moisture, insect. You can take the example of salt. Salt is available in a packaged plastic packet form, especially in the rainy season. If it is, and all the snacks items, in the rainy season, if they remain open, then there will be a problem. Salt will not be there. It will become water, or it will be very wet. So same is with the all the snacks items. So packaging provides the protection to the product. Clear? Protection from sun, rain, moisture, insect, etc. Second is product identification. It is very easy to identify the product with the help of a packaging. Suppose you want to buy Lay's. If a child, which is 2 years old, he is not able to read and write, and he wants to buy Lay's salted. Salted Lay's only, plain. So what color he will be selecting? Yes, bataiye. What color for Lay's he will be selecting? If you just want to simple Lay's potato chips. Yes, what color? Yes, very good. Everyone know, very good. Harshita, Pulkit, Vidyanshi, Piyush, very good. Piyush, you are wrong. Yellow color packet. So yellow color means the plain salted Lay's. So how the child was able to identify the salted Lay's packet just because of its packaging color. Different colors are used so that the consumer can easily identify that. One more example we can take. You can see that the many chocolates are available. If you want to buy, there is a rack where many chocolates are kept. Different chocolates, Amul chocolates, Cadbury chocolates, Five Star, and other chocolates. So if a child is very fond of Cadbury chocolate, he can easily identify among the 50 chocolates, he can easily identify the Cadbury chocolate because that is always available in purple color. Very good. That is always available in purple color. So packaging helps the consumer for the product identification. And specifically the consumers, the village people who are not able to read and write, or the small kids who are not Kinder Joy, they can easily identify the Kinder Joy. That is where all the children, small children are very much fond of Kinder Joy. So they can easily identify the Kinder Joy. How? Just because of its packaging, the shape of the packet. Yeah. Third is the, you can take, yes, you can take many more examples for product identification. Third is the facilitating the use of the product. Packaging helps for the use of the product. Like if the product is in package form, then it will be very convenient for the consumer to open it, to handle it, and to use for the consumer. Like shampoo package, shaving cream package, and Horlicks jo jar aate hai, so that are very much convenient to open it, to handle it, and to reuse it. Next, product promotion. Product promotion means attracting. Convincing the consumer. Sometime you must have seen the Diwali time. Let's remember it. At Diwali time, whenever we went to the shop for buying the gifts to our neighbors, to our relatives, then you must have seen that the packaging is very attractive. Very large packets are available at a price of 200, 250, 300. But when you come back and you just open the packet, then nothing is there. Only 4 packets of normal biscuits. 2 packets of Haldiram, Namkeen, snacks are kept in there. So why you have bought that particular packet? Just because of its attractive packaging. So it helps to product promotion. Promotion means convincing the consumer. Rising the standard of health. Yes, very much true. Packaging really raises the standard of health. How? Because in packaging helps the customer to save the customer from the adulteration, as the product is properly packed by the manufacturer and there is no chance of doing any adulteration on the part of wholesaler or on the part of retailer. Last, product differentiation. Product differentiation is a little bit similar to the product identification. If different hair oil bottles are kept in a rack, then you can easily identify the or you can easily differentiate the Parachute coconut oil from the Dabur Amla just because of packaging. So product differentiation. Packaging creates product differentiation. Blue color will be there. Packaging creates product differentiation. For example, by looking at the package of a product, say hair oil, one can make some guess about quality of the product contained in it, as well as identification is also there. So these all are the functions of packaging, and just have a quick recap what we have done today. Packaging meaning and why the packaging is known as a silent salesman. Then different levels of packaging, primary, secondary, and transportation. Primary and transportation is compulsory for each and everyone. Secondary package means only the additional layer. If you are in a position to bear the increased cost, then you can add up the secondary package. Then the functions or importance of packaging, product protection, product identification. If the functions and importance for both topics, maybe in your book, these two different topics will be given, but you need to do both topics simultaneously. Need not to learn the different points because all the points are same in both the topics. So product protection, product identification, facilitating the use of the product, then product promotion, rising the standard of health, product differentiation. All these are the importance or the functions of packaging. I hope topic is clear.